In this short video about SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard, we're going to look at managing design changes. We'll look at how PDM can help facilitate changing components within an assembly. We'll look at leveraging the search functionality in PDM on file open and file save commands. We'll look at how PDM enables us to preview previous design iterations. And also look at how PDM will enable the ease of engineering teams to work collaboratively together. So I have this assembly drawing open inside of SOLIDWORKS, and you'll notice that the file is read-only. We don't have write access to this file until we check out the file. And checkout permissions are governed by the workflow state that the file is in, and we can see this is in work in progress. So I have the ability to check out the drawing and the assembly file as well. So with these files open, I'm just going to go ahead and swap this component out. We've had a design review and this is the component we want to change for another component. So when I use the replace command inside of SOLIDWORKS, I have access to the file vault view and I can access the search commands. So by running a search, I can specify the name of the component that I want to find, run the search, and I can then select which component I'm going to insert into my design, and I have the ability to preview the component before I open it up inside of SOLIDWORKS here. So we've got the full preview, so I can look at the component I'm going to insert there. This is the component I want to swap the clip with that's open inside of SOLIDWORKS. So let's just go ahead and open that component. I'm not going to check out the file because I'm opening the file for reference only, and I can go ahead and commit those changes to this design there then. If we go back to the drawing file, we may want to add in an additional view there, but as soon as I save this, over on the right hand side, SOLIDWORKS gives us feedback. It tells me that the drawing and assembly file have been modified. And it also tells us who's modified this file. So I'm going to go ahead and check these two files in now. I can add in a comment. And we can add in a comment there, and that helps build up the audit trail for this design. Once I check the file in, the status of the file changes to read-only because we no longer have the file checked out. In the SOLIDWORKS task pane on the right hand side, we get visual feedback of the status of the files, so whether they're equal to what other users can see in PDM, whether they're newer or whether they're older. But from within this task pane, we can also go and look at earlier versions of a design by using the get version command. So I can then specify that I want to look at revision A and load revision A of the drawing file as it was built. So it will then retrieve all of the references, so PDM will know which version of each component was in use when it was checked into PDM. And we can see here that we've got red warnings just to denote that we are looking at out of date files. So when you're working in that collaborative environment, any changes that are made to components that you're working on collaboratively, you'll get feedback straight away as soon as somebody has made those changes. And if a colleague has made a change to a component and you want to then get that change, we can simply right click on each of these components and get latest version, and that will enable us to then go and retrieve the changes that have been made to those files in the PDM system. So using the get version command enables us to go and get any version of any design with ease. We can then use the get latest command, and that will then retrieve the assembly and drawing file with the latest references. If we take a look at in our local vault view now at this assembly and drawing file, we can view the bill of materials, but we don't necessarily know what's changed between each of the versions that we have generated. So rather than select through each of the versions manually, we have the ability to compare the bill of materials, so I can compare version 4 with version 5, and we can see with ease what components have been added or been deleted there. So PDM helps facilitate this collaborative working environment by allowing users to get newer files that have been checked into PDM, but also it allows us to manage change to components with relative ease. We don't have to remember or start copying files into different locations.